Hello and welcome. It has been a while since I last published a video, but today I have some interesting and hidden settings for the Oculus PC app, which you can enable right now. I'm first going to show you how you can get the debug features yourself. Go to the GitHub page for Skyline Patcher and download the latest release. The link for that is in the video description. Make sure you have the Oculus PC app installed and then execute the downloaded file. It should now patch and launch the Oculus PC app. If you want to reverse these changes, just press the Windows key and R, drag the downloaded .exe file to the dialog box and add --undo at the end of it and click OK. Everything should now be reversed to normal. The first thing you will notice after applying the patches is these four buttons in the bottom right. Button 1 is pretty simple and just opens the standard Chrome developer menu. You can use it to look at the requests sent from the Oculus client to the OVR server or to the internet. Clicking the second button reveals a hidden menu that allows us to see all the devices that have been connected to the PC and some information about them. On the left, you can see other menus. NUX stands for New User Experience and displays information about tutorials, instructions, and other setups currently active. You can trigger these sequences by clicking on the third button in the bottom right. There are a few to select from, but I will use Select Headset for demonstration purposes. Something interesting I noted was that the four buttons have moved from the bottom right to the bottom left, and an additional button was added after the third one, so that we now have five buttons. This one just allows us to provide feedback to Oculus, so it's not that interesting. While we're at it, I also want to show you the last button, which just takes a screenshot of the current window. We can skip the headset setup and continue with the next menu called Packages. It does what it says and shows us which packages we currently have installed, which version we have, if they are currently running, and what their app ID is. Packages include your VR games and other stuff like drivers and some other applications. Next we have Polaris. It seems like it's used for various user interface tests, for example input fields like checkboxes. To be honest, I'm not quite sure what the next option does, but it looks like it has something to do with text localization. And last but not least we have Events, where we can basically configure our own test event, but it's just visual, so no actual event is being created. This was everything about the tabs in the bottom right, and we can continue with settings that have been added. In the settings section, two tabs have been added, developer and debug. The developer tab only shows the current runtime version, so we focus on debug. Most of these options aren't very user friendly, so I'm only going over a few of them. On the top, we have the ability to change our release channel. This is basically the same option as in the beta tab. The next option allows us to set a custom test store. It seems like everything other than an empty text field redirects us to the same test store. Inside that store are some hidden test games that don't really exist in the normal store, but you can't download or play them. Then we have the ability to crash the OVR server. We can reset the health and safety warning and run a USB benchmark. After that, we have a list of internal packages we've already seen in the beginning. A bit further down, we have a list of gatekeepers. Gatekeepers decide what you are able to do and see. For example, Oculus RR AUI for all settings decides whether you can toggle the AUI setting at the top. As you can see, nothing changes and the OVR server console tells us that this is because of the gatekeeper. But I was still able to find out what it does and enable it manually via the registry. Other interesting gatekeepers are for example the gatekeeper setting for Infinite Office. The same gatekeeper system also exists on the Oculus Quest, but that should be harder to bypass. In the end, I would like to thank NiaMimi for the patches I used. They were quite a bit better than my original patches, because they patched the function that decides if you are allowed to use these features, while my patch only enabled the feature itself. Thanks for watching this video, I will see you next time, and in case you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section.